few words regarding that. The evidence comes up in that same equity verse. So you just going to explain what is the stand of political council as and today about the same equity verse.
Dear members, 2012 to 2017, we have been able to compile your attendance at CME program in Kodambakkam branch. We have submitted the same. The same has been awarded for credit hours and uploaded into the Tamil Nadu Medical Council website. We have not obtained or asked for individual credit hour certificates because it is not necessary. All we need is that Tamil Nadu Medical Council should know that we have the mandatory credit hours, so we have uploaded it. If individual members want to go and check how many hours they have, you have to get in a login ID and password from Tamil Nadu Medical Council. You will get an individual account page where you can check your name, address, etc., upload your photographs, update your email and mobile number, and then check how many credit hours you have. Now, those people who don't have the credit hours, don't worry about it yet, because Tamil Nadu Medical Council is yet to decide and pass as a rule saying that this many credit hours for expiring in this year. That is what they have so far clear on is we should have 30 credit hours every block of 5 years. This they are very much clear on. But some people in interior Tamil Nadu and other places are objecting, why should suddenly this credit hour be made mandatory? What registration certificate given to us is permanent registration certificate, so now we can't make it temporary, etc. So Medical Council is still thinking whether we should have the cutoff date as 2017 or whether it should be extended to 2019-20, etc. As far as members are concerned, try to get 5 CME credit hours or 6 CME credit hours every year. So you will be on the safer side. Our meetings, individual meetings, will get you half credit hour. But for the period of 2012 to 17, we have been able to get 3/4 credit hour per meeting. So therefore, many of the members who previously thought, when we circulated the preliminary paper, who previously thought that they may not have the enough credit hours, possibly they have enough credit hours. From now on, please make it sure, if you attend every CME monthly meeting of IMA Kodambakkam, you will definitely get your mandatory 6 credit hours. Otherwise, whichever way you can make up by attending API meetings or other meetings, please say to it that you get 6 credit hours per year. We suggest that you come to IMA because we will have numbers, we will have good discussion, and then we can take it forward. The last meeting which we held in Green Park, or 4-day meeting, 3 credit hours have been given by Tamil Nadu Medical Council, and this has already been uploaded in the Tamil Nadu Medical Council website under the individual registration numbers of those doctors who attended. Thank you. Point about Clinical Establishment Act, many of us have already registered and many of us have already got the certificates. Those of you people who have not yet registered, the last date is 31st May. That is, we have about 1 month from now on. The CEA committee is expecting about 60,000 registrations. They have, till the end of last month, got only about 2,000 registrations. This means that many of us have not registered. This means that those of us who are waiting for the last day to register will face website crashes like what happened during the end of last month, when many people complained that they could not log in. This also means that the inspecting team which comes to your individual clinics or hospitals or consulting rooms will do a haphazard job because they have a target point to achieve or an end period to achieve. It is better to register early. If any of you individual members have any doubts regarding CEA, you are most welcome to call up any of the executive committee members, because most of us members are already registered and got the licenses, and we will be able to help you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. There is a small change in the next speaker, Dr. Ashok is unfortunately not available. So Dr. Balamurugan will be speaking the next topic on knee arthritis, what works and what does not. A short CV about him: he has completed his undergraduate from Ramchandra and D-Ortho from Ramchandra. And he did his DNB orthopedics from Sundaram Medical Foundation. And he is basically a pediatric orthopedician who has completed his fellowship in Kanchi Kamakoti Children's Hospitals and has obtained training in the NHS UK for a period of 3 years. And right now he is a consultant pediatric orthopedician in Rail Institute of Medical Sciences. Over to you, sir.
Good evening to one and all. I know you're all tired and want to leave. At the outset, I would like to thank IMA Kodambakkam for having me here. I'll talk in short, right in basic, about this interesting topic, knee arthritis. Now, why I chose knee arthritis is because, you know, the longevity of the population is increasing. The average lifespan is now 67 in India, as per the new survey. And also the functional demand of the people are also increasing, which is a good thing. So arthritis is again something inevitable, like most aging disorders. It's, I think we need to know what all we have in the armamentarium to treat this difficult problem. So just a short introduction to my team. I represent the Rail Institute of Orthopedics, which is a part of the Institute and Medical Center of Bombay. So we have four colleagues, four consultants with different specialities, and we're hoping that we'll cover all these specialities in orthopedics, like arthroplasty, complex trauma, myself, pediatric orthopedics, and labral reconstruction, and one other colleague for arthroscopy and spine service. Now, before I move on, let me get my basics right. I think.